First and foremost, I thank the sponsor for answering my questions. I offer, you know, the following remarks based on conversations that I've had with people in my district, my constituency. If I were a journalist, if I were part of the press corps, front page would be easy for me tomorrow. It would say train wreck on it. Because quite frankly, as lawmakers, we are in fact supposed to be problem solvers. And what we are doing, we are kicking a dented can down the road once again. And what is happening, quite frankly, is this policy is highlighting just how ineffective and inept state government actually is. The reality is that it shows how disconnected from everyday New Yorkers that we currently are. The ERAP program, we talked a lot about that today. The fact is there are thousands and thousands of tenants who are simply too lazy to fill out the paperwork and get involved in the program because there's no incentive for them to be part of the program. You are staying in someone's home, you are living in their property, and there are no repercussions for not paying. So I think what we're doing today is we're sending, or at least some of us in this body, are sending a very clear message to the property owners that exist in the state of New York. If you maintain your property, if you pay your taxes, if you have invested your hard-earned money in bought property for other people to live, we don't care about you. I heard about having tremendous sympathy for property owners. If we had sympathy for property owners, if this body cared as much as we claim that we do, we would get every single dollar out the door into the hands of the property owners that are struggling. That's not happening, in my humble opinion, because the reality is that that is not what some want. There is a desire to eviscerate the rights of property owners and allow people to live rent-free forever. You could get hit by a bus walking down the road, and there are some in this statehouse that would blame COVID. Mr. President, I vote no.